In this video, I give you my tips, tricks, and tools for virtual background using a DIY green screen. You might be more familiar with the green screen technology if you are joining a Zoom meeting from your smartphones, especially nowadays during the COVID lockdown. Green screen has been used for many years in TV production, like a newsroom similar to this photo. Green screen is also called chroma key technique. Chroma is a word borrowed from Greek meaning color. It is easier to change your background using the smartphones, but in desktop, Zoom has the requirements, which I put in the link below. For example, without a green screen at my back, using Zoom in my Mac will give me this error message. So what are the alternatives? These are the ideas I got from other bloggers. The first is using a green screen app. I noticed that when bloggers say get a green screen easily, they refer to using their mobile phone. I find that the phone is not user-friendly if you are the one hosting a meeting and managing the settings yourself. Another alternative that was suggested is pasting several green papers on the wall. That is tricky as you need to make sure that no paper won't peel off during your webinar. Others would recommend painting your wall green. You have to make sure it is a smooth wall and you use a matte paint as light reflection might affect and make the green screening difficult. Another blogger recommended buying from online shops. However, aside from the fact that during this lockdown it will be challenging, you have to be careful with the measurements. You need a wide cloth and the photos in online shops might not be the same as in the descriptions. For example, I already bought a white background and it is narrow, unlike what it was posted online. So what I really did was to rummage through a box of old clothes and I found a square tablecloth. See how I set it up so that the top edges are fixed in place with three big books. And here I recorded myself with a green background and selected virtual backgrounds using the three default images of Zoom. So I give you some more tips. You must also check if your real background is showing, so you need to make adjustments. Here I was moving my computer to the left or right and moving it closer to me. Another tip if you will use a DIY green screen is to iron or make sure that the cloth is stretched neatly, as the folds can again give you problems. For example, here you don't see much the error in my green screen, but I change background and the folds are more apparent. You must remember to use licensed images. Perhaps now you might be doing the webinar only for your students, but if in the future you would like to upload that in a public site like in YouTube, then you need to make sure you really have license to use the images. There are sites for royalty-free images like Pexels. Here I show you how to search in Google for photos labeled for reuse. And here I show you how to check for rights in Flickr for one image I use in this video. As I am a YouTuber and this is my business right now, I have a license and Bato Elements account where I can access thousands of images. I put the link below if you're interested. My last advice is to be cautious in choosing your background. It must not distract from the learning experience of your viewers. For example, you could avoid showing your messy surroundings, but you have chosen a mansion. So if your viewers know who you are, they could be distracted with a background that is not you in an authentic way. So let me know what green screen you use or you plan to use in your online classes or webinars. And see you in the next one.